Chef Mark with August Escoffier, School of Culinary Arts. We're excited that you are planning to enroll in our program soon. The first day of class is very important to us, and we're glad you're here today to see some of the great cooking skills that we have and that you will learn while you're in class. Now, when I first enrolled in culinary school, I was apprehensive myself about what will happen and will I be successful? Who's going to help me during my transition? And of course, our campuses have a student success coordinator, and they help you achieve your success. And most important with that is they help you in the transition from where you're currently living to housing and also job placement with our Director of Career Services. So these people exist at our campuses, and our Director of Career Services can help you find that part-time employment to help you through to make some payments. Our program is real-world setting, and our faculty are very approachable. They've been selected because they're great chefs, but also because they like to share what they know and love, the passion for the culinary arts or baking and pastry. So I think you'll find that very, very encouraging. Students, there's 18 or 20 students, one chef instructor. That's quite dynamic, and it's a formula that's been working for many years. If you have a passion to learn, that's important, and those are the things that you need to be aware of to be successful no matter what field you choose. The culinary profession can be quite demanding, but it takes tenaciousness, right? Tenacity, willingness to work, to do the things necessary, to study, to do the homework, and to have fun cooking, because that's what it's all about. One thing about our program is kind of unique from the rest is that we have a farm-to-table component. That's not an herb garden where you cut herbs in the backyard, but it's where you spend 3 weeks with farmers on farms or ranches. That's unique. That's very cutting edge. Now, regarding our curriculum with Escoffier, August Escoffier and his family, his great-grandson, Michel Escoffier, who works with us, we know about the time-tested recipes, methods, and skills that have made Chef Escoffier's name still what it is today, 100 or so years later. So the classics endure because they are wonderful. The hollandaise sauces, the mother sauces, the proper method of sauteing, the proper method of broiling, the proper method of grilling, how to poach properly, how to roast, all those things Escoffier put together and codified, of course, in his landmark book, Le Guide Culinaire by August Escoffier. Over 5,000 recipes, of which 600 are desserts. So it's a great book, great reference book, one that you find and that you use, that chefs use today worldwide. Ask any chef, does he know about August Escoffier? He'll say yes. He was the foremost theoretician of modern cuisine, and that's pretty exciting when you think about his legacy. Our curriculum is also industry-based. We have advisory board members who spend time with us to go through the curriculum to make sure it fits what you need to know out in the food world today, out in the culinary profession, out in the food service or hospitality industry. We look forward to chatting with you shortly and hope you enjoy the program we have in store for you right now.
We're going to work with quinoa today. Quinoa is a super grain, very nutritious for you. It's a very popular grain over the past few years. It's got a lot of nutrients. It's got a lot of minerals, fibers. It's what we call a super grain because it's got pretty much all the nutrients that you can think of are packed in that little bit of grain. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a quinoa salad, a cold salad. You can use quinoa as a hot application and as a cold application. So today we're going to use it as a cold application. And for that, we're going to use apple cranberry and quinoa salad. So the ingredients we're going to need, it's going to be some red quinoa, oil, dry cranberries, roasted almonds. We're going to use some apple, salt, pepper, a little bit of Dijon mustard, and a little bit of red wine. And the way we're going to start it is we're going to put the quinoa into a pot with water. We're going to bring the water to a boil. And once that's starting to boil, we're going to reduce the flame. We're going to cook it for about 15 to 20 minutes until the quinoa is nice and soft, and you can see the brine starting to open up a little bit. So we're going to let that do that, and then we're going to go ahead and build the salad. So we have that quinoa already cooked. We cooled it down, removed it from the water. We let it cool down on the refrigerator for about 10 to 15 minutes until it was nice and cold. So we're going to build our vinaigrette, all right? So for this salad, we're going to use a red wine vinaigrette. Vinaigrette is super simple. We're going to grab a stainless steel bowl. We're going to need a whisk. So we're going to pour the red wine vinegar on the bowl. I'm gonna add a little bit of Dijon mustard. A little bit of salt and pepper. And we're gonna dissolve the mustard into the oil. I'm sorry, dissolve the mustard into the vinegar. And once that's ready, we're gonna slowly add the oil while whisking the vinegar. So that's gonna incorporate the oil, is gonna form what we call an emulsion. So emulsify the oil and the vinegar together. So you want a nice constant stream of the oil as you're whisking these. And normally for a basic vinaigrette, we use a 3-to-1 ratio. So 3 parts of oil to 1 part of vinegar. So whatever you use to measure your vinaigrette, it's just 3-to-1. If you want a little bit more on the tart side, a little more vinegary, go to a 2-to-1.5-to-1. If you want it a little bit more oily, then you want to go to like a 3.5-to-1 ratio. So, and as you do this, as the oil starts to incorporate and it starts to form a stable, you can actually go a little faster on this oil, so you can pour a little bit more at a time. So once we have the dressing, let's season it again with a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper. And just to taste, you know, if you want to taste this and see how much oil or salt you need, or if you need a little bit more pepper. So once we have that, when I set that to aside for just a second, and we're actually going to start building our salad. So what we're going to do is grab another clean bowl. We're going to bring our quinoa into the bowl. I'm gonna add the apples that we diced. I'm gonna add the dry cranberries and the roasted almonds. We're gonna toast that together, make sure that kind of makes a nice spread evenly all over the all the ingredients, the quinoa, there's no chunks of one and chunks of the other. So once we have that, we're gonna add a little bit of the vinegar and just kind of toss it around a little bit of the vinaigrette and make sure that all the vinaigrette covers the entire salad. You don't want a lot of vinegar because what's gonna happen, you don't want a lot of vinaigrette in it because what's gonna happen is that it's gonna get too saggy. So you want a little bit of crunchiness from the almonds and the apples. And so you don't wanna add a lot of it. You don't want the ingredients to be swimming in the vinaigrette, but you do want it to be nice and covered on the vinaigrette. Okay, so we mix our vinaigrette and our salad, so we're gonna go ahead and start cleaning it up. And just basic plate, make sure it's nice and neat, clean plate. And there it is, you can see it's really super simple to make, doesn't take a lot of time, and again, the quinoa, you can use it in a lot of different ways.
This is Chef Thomas with chickpea salad. We're gonna make a wonderful light salad with chickpeas as a main component. We're gonna use a bowl with that. We have chickpeas right here. Now these are regular canned chickpeas. We actually have to mash them up a little bit because we need that to be a good pasty substance. Otherwise, our wraps are not going to hold together. We're going to keep a couple whole, a couple mashed up. Perfect mix here. We're also going to put some celery in here. Some pickles, some red onions, fresh minced garlic, some dill, mustard, You can either use stone ground mustard or Dijon. We use Dijon in this recipe. A little bit of lemon juice. You can always add a little bit more later on, so we want to be careful with the consistency. And last but not least, some toasted sunflower seeds. Seeds are very healthy. They have essential oils. These were also a little bit salted, so we might want to wait with the salt, but I'm definitely going to put some pepper in there. Now guess what? If you like it spicy, throw some jalapenos in there. It looks almost a little bit like a tuna salad. So it gets like a nice creamy consistency when you use some of these chickpeas and you cream them up. It smells fantastic. Now it was fresh dill. If you don't have fresh dill at home and you use dried dill, be careful that you don't use too much. It's more potent. It's about a 1-to-3 ratio. Now this looks wonderful. I'm going to put up just a little bit more lemon juice in here. But this smells fantastic. So, I just have regular flour tortillas here. You could use any kind of tortillas, spinach, roasted tomatoes, roasted pepper, whatever you find in the grocery store. See, I'm pushing here a little bit against so I know how much filling I have in here. I'm just going to roll them. Make maybe a second one. This is a really nice snack. If you maybe eat or serve two of them, it's probably a really good lunch too. And there's no meat in there. So it's vegetarian. It's a very, very refreshing smell and taste. The rest you can even put maybe on a salad. So here you have your chickpea salad wrap with chickpeas, celery, toasted sunflower seeds.
Now that you saw that great demo by our chef, you can see how cutting edge our methods are. Even though they're classic, they're modern in their interpretation. Be mindful that it's hands-on. You'll be cooking a menu each day. A six-hour class day, and it's a wonderful program. It goes on, and the learning increases, and it's like working up a set of stairs. Each day, you acquire more knowledge. Sometimes you step back one, and then you move up two. Sometimes you step back two. As long as you learn that, you take each benchmark and move forward, we know you'll be successful. Also, think about your classmates. They have lots of knowledge, too. There are different age groups and backgrounds with the Food Network and the World Wide Web, lots of food knowledge out there. So you can build that critical mass with your classmates. Lastly, look forward to telling you when you arrive your first day about the great externship program, 10 weeks externship. Those are usually paid. And finally, I want to say to you that we're excited to have you with August Escoffier Schools. Please email us for any questions. And I look forward to seeing you the first day of class. See you then. Have a great day. Bye-bye.